Hi everyone, it's Asia here, and today I have for you a tutorial on how to use Lindy's with alcohol and on photo paper. Last time I've made this project on the Yupo paper, this time I have something different for you. So let's start. These are the products I'm gonna be using. So there is a photo paper, glossy photo paper, Lindy's and 90% alcohol, which I put in this small spray bottle. And these are the colors I'm gonna be using for the first stack. So it's Midnight Rendezvous Raven, Hydrangea Blue, and Afternoon Delight Denim. And as you can see me, I'm spraying them randomly, the three colors. I'm not drying in between, I decided to do it like that. Of course you can change it, you can dry it in between. Maybe the effect will be different, I actually didn't check that. And then on top of the colors I'm adding with the spray bottle the alcohol. Remember it has to be 90% alcohol for the best effects. And I also prepare alcohol in a small pipette, I think it's called, this small thing. See-through thing, which makes the drops, which I'm adding to the paper. And so that's how I'm working. I'm just mixing everything and drying now. And again, adding a little bit of alcohol. And I don't know if you've seen either on my channel or Lindy's Gang channel the previous movie when I used alcohol with Lindy's, but on Yupo paper. The effects are actually better on Yupo paper. I don't know why is that. Well, it's a paper, I guess, which works very well with alcohol. And here now I'm actually using a watercolor paper just to show you the difference. It looks lovely when you spray it with alcohol. And I'm still even on the regular paper here to show you the difference. I'm spraying it with alcohol, the same colors. But I just wanted you to show you to see the difference between that's the regular watercolor paper. It's still gorgeous, the effects are gorgeous, but they look more like you would spray the inks with Lindy's inks with water. Look at that though. I don't know if it's the alcohol effect or it's the fact that it's a photo paper, but the shine is just amazing. The paper is the photo paper is very thin. So it's actually bended a little, warped, but later I'm gonna glue it, so this is gonna be not visible. And now I'm gonna be working on the second tag, and I'm using Tears on My Pillow Tangerine and French Lilac Violet, and then Oktoberfest Orange and Prima Donna Purple. So I'm using also shakers, magical shakers, but you can of course use just magicals. Just to see the effects I'm gonna get with it, and I'm doing exactly the same as I've done with the first stack. So I was talking to you before, I think I lost the thought there, about doing this process already on the Yupo paper with alcohol, and it's actually it's amazing how beautiful effects you can get on Yupo paper, because you get a lot of stains. You get beautiful, beautiful stains. It looks really beautiful. And I really like it, but not everybody has a Yupo paper. And also, on Yupo paper you get a lot of stains. On the photo paper you get this very, very shiny and kind of smooth effect. You don't have stains. The colors are mixing together very smoothly. And on the regular paper, just with water, you get also different effect. So what I'm trying is to show you a few techniques. Because the effects when you use Lindy's, and as I mentioned before, no matter if you use powders or sprays, are really, really stunning and different on different papers. And that's what I like. I like to experiment, I like to see things different, I like to do things differently. And that's what this project is all about, but I cannot leave the paper just like that. So I'm gonna continue, and I'm gonna make out of these two pieces two tags, and I don't know if you've noticed here that the tag for which I used the purple and orange colors, it got a lot of pink color in it, which is nice also, maybe not totally Halloween, but well, it's nice, I like also. And Because I'm talking and I'm not telling you what I'm actually using at this moment. You have a frozen screen, but as always, I'm gonna give you the full list. This is Blazing Black Magical, it's not very clear. I'm gonna give you the full list of products in the description box below, also on my blog, you can find it, and also on Lindy's blog. So I was adding to the tags a little bit of stamping, and now I'm using, I'm adding stencils from AB Studio with a texture paste from Finnabair, which I mixed with Blazing Black Magical, because I didn't like the fact that the texture was not totally black, and for the Halloween tag, of course I need black. And I'm also gonna give you, in the description box below, I'm gonna give you a link to my previous video with Lindy's powders and sprays, alcohol and Yupo paper, so you can see the difference if you haven't seen the video before. And as I said, I love very much Lindy's. I work with them a lot, or almost only with it, you know, with Lindy's, and the effects are so different, really. I love to work with them on the regular paper, on the watercolor paper, and also on Yupo and even photo paper. The effects are really nice. It's just I love doing art journaling, so I cannot do art journaling on Yupo paper, not too much. And now I build up more or less my background. I'm gonna be adding embellishments. So I'm gonna be adding something which is called Ayyeda Powder. But to me it reminds me a little of mica flakes. And then I'm gonna be adding some Industrious stickers by Tim Holtz and Ephemera, Halloween Ephemera pack. Well, not pack, but few bits and pieces from Tim Holtz. And I have some leftover from the paste I was using earlier, from the sand paste, and I'm gonna I'm adding it to the borders. And I don't know if you can see it, I actually cut the paper a little bit. The tags are smaller now. And I made also a base for it. I like to put the black base under my ATC cards or under my tags. I think it looks more elegant and also more finished. I have no idea why, but that's just how I feel. And on top of that, as I said, the photo paper is very, very thin. It kind of gets warped during the process, so it needs to be glued down, and I'm using for that, how do you call that? Double-sided tape, exactly. I'm also adding some stapling, and both because it's a Halloween, there are Halloween tags, so they have to be weird and with some kind of stapling on them, to me anyway. And here you go, these two packs from Tim Holtz, Ephemera and Industrious stickers. And I'm just building my background. I did not want to cover completely again the tags, so you can see the colors. But I have to tell you that neither the pictures nor the video is giving the real colors, and you can see the light being what you call that, being reflected in the text, so you cannot really see too much. I had very big problems to take photos also. And I'm adding here die cuts. They are beautiful, beautiful die cuts from Fantasy Dice. It's a Russian company which is producing these die cuts, and I really love them. And adding again a little bit of stapling, and just to make the embellishments blend nicely together with the background and with the whole text, I like to ink the edges, and I'm using black archival ink and the sponge because the edges are not straight, so it's difficult to do it otherwise. And I'm using a moon, I don't know where is it from, but I really like this, for me it's very Halloween-like also. And now I'm gonna be working on my cabochon, these glass pebbles. And I actually cannot use Lindy's on them because the Lindy's just don't stick. I need a heavy body acrylic paint. And I'm covering the backs of them. It's a very messy job because you cannot really hold them steady. But look at that after drying. They are just beautiful. So they're gonna go to my tags. And I'm gluing them with 3D matte gel. And the last part of the process is to make a ribbon. I'm using a muslin lace, and I'm using blazing black and French lilac violet. And just remember, when you do that, put the gloves on, because later you're gonna have big problems with your fingers. The paint will stick to it. And what I learned from other artists is, when you do that and you wanna have a distressed look while drying them, you have to put some kind of paper clips. I think they are called paper clips, I'm not sure. And then they are all creased and really nicely looking. So guys, that's it. As I told you, all the list of products, here I change also because the tag was white, so I add some color, but I'll get you all the list of products I've used in the description box below, and also the link to my previous video. Hope you enjoyed that, hope I gave you another idea, another technique, and that you're gonna experiment with Lindy's, because it's really worth it. Wish you all a beautiful day, and see you soon, bye!